It's that time of the year when we do an uninstallation video. So let's learn how to uninstall Oracle Database 19c from Windows 10. What's up, internet? I am Manish from rebellionwriter.com. Welcome back once again. Today in this video, I will show you the proper way of uninstalling Oracle Database 19c from your Windows operating system. Though I am using Windows 10 operating system for the demonstration, but you can follow same steps for uninstalling Oracle 19c from any Windows operating system. Now, without wasting much of your time, let's get on to the tutorial.
Step 1. Delete the environment variable. If you are planning to reinstall Oracle Database and you don't want to get an error saying environment variable path is too long, then deleting environment variable is something you should do. Let's do that. The quickest way to do that is by using search utility of Windows 10. Just press Windows key and Q. That will launch the search panel. Now, search environment variable. This will show you edit the system environment variables app. Just open it. Doing so will open up the advanced tab of system properties. Here, click on this button named environment variables. Now, you must have your environment variables window right in front of you. Next, come to this system variables section and search variable name path. Just double click and open it. Here, you will see a list of all the environment variables. Don't delete anything here except the location of your Oracle home. In my case, this location looks something like this. This could be different in your case, so be careful and delete accordingly. Anyways, select the variable and press delete. That's all you have to do. Now press OK and exit. With this, step number 1 is complete. Now let's move on to step number 2. Step 2. Delete the registries of Oracle Database 19c. This is the most important as well as crucial step of the process. You need to be very careful here. You don't want to delete any registry other than those which are related to your Oracle Database 19c. Deleting wrong registries could result in crashing your system. So I would suggest you to take the backup of your registries first. It's great if you know how to take the backup, but in case if you don't, then just for you, I have done a quick video on my Facebook page explaining how to take backup of registries. Go ahead and watch that. I will leave the link in the description. Anyways, let's come to the registries that we have to delete. First, open up the registry editor. For that, the command will be regedit. You can use this command either in run dialog box or in search utility of the Windows operating system. Anyways, here we have our registry editor. Now we have to delete a bunch of registries. Let's see where they are located. Before performing this step, you need to take care of two things. These are, first, only delete the registries that are mentioned in this video. Second, if you have any other software from Oracle installed on your system, then consult your admin before deleting anything. That being said, now let's move ahead. Okay, first go to /hkey_local_machine. Next, go to system. And then current control set. And here you will have to go to services. Once you are inside the services directory, you will have to find and delete all the registries whose names start with Oracle. Be very careful, only delete the registries whose names start with Oracle and nothing else. Anyways, let's search for those registries. Here they are. Here we have total 6 registries whose names start with the word Oracle. Now, take a deep breath and delete those 6 registries carefully one by one. Done! Wait, don't go anywhere, as there is one more registry that we have to delete. For that, we have to go back to the root, which is hkey_local_machine. Great, so here we are. This time, go to this folder, software, and search for the registry named Oracle. Here it is. Select it and delete it.
That's it. Step 2 complete. You know what we have to do next? Restart the computer. In order to bring all the changes that we have made into effect, it's necessary to restart the system. Let's do that. While the system is rebooting, I just want to ask you to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't already and press the bell icon to get notified. Also, did you know that my Instagram is on fire lately? I am sharing info-packed posts every next day there. If you haven't followed me, then come and join me right away. After hitting that follow button, make sure to send me a DM and let me know that you are coming from YouTube. Anyways, system has restarted. Let's get back to it and move on to the next step of uninstalling Oracle Database 19c from our Windows 10. Here we are.
Step 3. Delete Oracle Home Users and Groups. For the proper working of the Oracle Database Management System, the OUI, Oracle Universal Installer, creates several Windows groups. To manage these groups, it creates a Windows user. In this step, we will delete all those Windows groups and users. To move ahead, we first need to open Local Users and Groups window. And it is very easy. There must be a command flashing on your screen, lusrmgr.msc. You can either search this command in the search utility of the Windows 10, or you can directly write it down in the Run dialog box. Last time, so many of viewers complained that Windows 10 is not recognizing the lusrmgr.msc command. In that case, what you can do, right-click on your Start menu and select Computer Management. And from there, click and select System Tools. And then select and double click on Local Users and Groups option. That's it. Anyways, inside your Local Users and Groups utility, you will have to first select Groups. Doing so will show you the list of all the groups that are created in your Windows OS. Here, we will have to delete only those groups that are related to Oracle Database. Finding them is very easy. Select only those groups which have ORA prefixed to their names. Wait, if along with Oracle 19c, there are other software from Oracle installed on your system, then be careful to delete only those that are being shown to you on the screen. For your convenience, I will leave the name of all the Oracle Database 19c groups in the corresponding blog. You can find the link in the description. There are total 14 groups created for Oracle 19c. We will have to delete only these. Let's do that. Great, done. All the Oracle Database 19c Windows groups are deleted. Now, let's delete the Windows user. For that, click and select Users. Doing so will show you all the users created in your Windows 10. Here you will have to delete the user that you have created during the installation of Oracle Database 19c. In my case, that user was Rebellion Rider. Therefore, I'm going to delete this Rebellion Rider. Done. User deleted. With this, step 3 is complete. Now, let's move on to step 4. Step 4. Delete Oracle Database 19c. We will be deleting directories from two different locations. So, watch the video till the end. Now, we will first delete all the directories of Oracle Database 19c, including Oracle Home, that were created during the installation. In my case, all the Oracle Database 19c related directories and files are placed inside the folder named app, which I have created in my C drive. Here it is. I'm going to delete all these directories. Select all and delete. In case you face problems while deleting any of these files and directories, then don't panic. First, restart your system and then try again. If that doesn't work, then reboot your Windows 10 in safe mode and then delete that file or folder. All the files and folders are deleted. Now go to Program Files and here search for the folder with name Oracle. Here it is. Select and delete. Done.
So, that's how we uninstall Oracle Database 19c from our Windows 10 operating system. Hope you enjoyed watching. If so, then please hit the thumbs up button and like the video. Also, click here to watch the next video and here to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We'll see you next week. Till then, take care. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.